Hello everyone, today I am going to start the propellant. The slides will cover its introduction, general characteristics and classification of propellant. Propellant is made up of two words, pro and pellor. Pro means forward and pellor means pushing. So any substance which is used to push forward a vehicle is known as propellant. Or in simple words, we can say the substances which are used for propulsion of rocket are known as rocket propellants or rocket fuels. These are the chemical substances which are used to produce energy or pressurized gas, which are further used to create fluid movement and generate the propulsion of a vehicle. They usually consist of fuel and oxidizers. Once they ignite it, they burn to produce gases in large quantity. These gases then come out through the nozzle of the rocket motors. So the backward ejection of hot gases with high velocity will provide a thrust for rockets to move forward. In man's first journey to the moon, kerosene and liquid oxygen were used as a rocket fuel. Once the reaction takes place between the kerosene and liquid oxygen, they will produce carbon dioxide, water and intense heat, which will drove the exhaust gases downward and produce a thrust which is required to boost the rocket. Propellant should have certain characteristics. It should have high specific impulse. Specific impulse is a measure of how effectively a rocket uses the propellants. We can say it tells about the thrust delivered, which is divided by the rate of propellant, which is burnt. So specific impulse mainly depend on the absolute temperature and molecular mass. We can represent it with the formula S is equals to T over M, which is in under root. It should produce low molecular weight gases as well as non-toxic gaseous product on combustion. Propellant should have the low ignition delay. Ignition delay is the time which is taken by the propellants to catch fire in presence of the oxidant. So the ignition delay should be low and the fuel should combust properly. They should be non-corrosive and non-hygroscopic in nature. The propellant should produce high temperature when they get combust. They should be non-toxic and easily available. The density is another important criteria for propellant. The propellant should be high in density because the heavier material can be carried out in smaller tanks in compared to the material which have the low density. The propellants can be classified in two categories, solid propellants and liquid propellants. Solid propellants are further classified in two categories on the basis of their phase, homogeneous and heterogeneous solid propellants. Solid propellant consists of solid fuel as well as oxidant. Solid fuel can be metallic powders, nitrocellulose or some polymer matrix. The oxidants are generally used as ammonium perchlorate, potassium chlorate, ammonium nitrate, etc. Solid propellants are categorized into two categories. First is composite propellant, that is heterogeneous solid propellant. In this category, fuel and oxidizer are used separately. So, both are present in different phases. For example, magnesium or aluminium can be used as fuel. They are metallic powder. Ammonium perchlorate can be used as oxidizer, as well as polybutadiene, acrylics, polyurethane can be used as a polymer matrix which will hold the propellant, fuel and oxidizer into the polymer matrix. They are used in larger rocket motors like SLV-3 and ASLV. Rockets in India has used the composite propellants. Double base solid propellants. In this category, fuel and oxidizers are present in single colloidal phase. For example, nitrocellulose dissolved in nitroglycerin makes a double base propellant which is in a single colloidal phase. So we tell them as a homogeneous solid propellant. Some additives can be added to control their physical and chemical properties. They are generally used in small arms, motors, rockets or cannons. The advantages with the solid fuels are they are easier to store as well as handle in compared to liquid propellant system, liquid propellants. They can be launched with high speed and high efficiency. High propellant density makes their sizes compact as possible. Their design is very simple and their cost is low, so they are ideal for military applications. Now coming to the liquid propellants. Usually the liquid propellants are introduced in combustion chamber in form of liquids. They have very high specific impulse and they are capable of being throttled, shut down and restart. That means they can be controlled even after ignited. Mostly they are separate fuel as well as separate oxidizers. For example, kerosene, gasoline, hydrazine, alcohol, liquid hydrazines can be used as fuels. Whether nitric oxide, nitric acid, nitrogen tetroxides, hydrogen peroxides, liquid oxygen, liquid fuels are used as oxidizers. In general, liquid oxygen and liquid hydrogen make a good liquid propellant. Oxygen with ethanol is also a liquid propellant. Both are the examples of bipropellant system in which fuel and oxidizers are present separately. While hydrazine and hydrogen peroxide can be used as monopropellant without using any specific fuel. They can act as a fuel as well as oxidizer. They decompose and gives the and produces the gases with exothermic reaction. They are used to provide energy in manned space travel. So basically, propellants are used in space chemistry. They are used in rocket fuels to launch the missile. They are used in fireworks and research vehicle, space launch vehicle. They are used for supersonic shield as well as target drones. Thank you.